So in the previous session, we are discussing about a boy. What kind of boy? A kind boy. So the boy's kindness was exposed. How? We will see in today's session. So in the first stanza, we came across an old woman. So what kind of woman do you find in the first stanza or in the poem? Yeah. She was an old woman. She was a poor woman. She wore torn dress. Correct? And grey means she had grey hair. That means she was an old woman. She was very weak. Correct? Unable to cross the road. Am I right? Then, next. Where was she standing? Yeah, the old woman was standing at the crossing. Why? To cross the road. Why couldn't she cross the road? She was weak. She was old. Correct? She was not strong. Am I right? Yeah. She needed a helping hand to cross the road. Then, how long she was waiting for? She was waiting for a long time. Nobody came to her rescue. Nobody came to her help. Correct? Then, she was unnoticed. She was uncared. Correct? Nobody paid attention to her. She was waiting. She was looking at others with the anxious eye. Now, how did the boys come out of the school? With laughter, with joy, correct? With shout, they came. So what are the boys compared to? The boys are compared to a flock of sheep, correct? Then, did they offer a helping hand to the old woman? No, they did not offer a helping hand to the old woman, correct? Yeah. Now, come to the next stanza, fifth stanza. She was hesitating. She was not ready to cross the road. She was unable to cross the road. She was not in a position to cross the road. Correct? She was hesitating to cross the road. Why? Why did they stand there itself? Lest the carriage wheels or the horse's feet should crowd her down in the slippery street. At last came one of the merry troop, the gayest lady of all the group. See the fifth stanza. Lest, where is she? She is standing at the crossing. Correct? Lest means otherwise. Lest means otherwise. If she dares to cross the road, she stands there, she stops there, she was waiting there, otherwise, lest. The carriage wheels, carriage means vehicle. Carriage wheels means vehicles. Carriage means vehicle. Vehicles, wheels are the horse's feet. Horse, singular. Horses, plural. Horses after S. Kuduregala. Correct? Horses feet. Feet plural. Foot singular. So horses feet, kuduregala kaal. Enaktade. Should crowd her down. So she was afraid of horses feet or carriage wheels, vehicles wheels. So what would they do? Should crowd her down. Crowd down means knock her down. They may hit her. Correct? Then knock her down, crowd her down in the slippery street. Anyhow, the street is covered with what? Slippery snow. It is slippery street. So she was afraid of the slippery street. She was afraid of the horse's feet. She was afraid of the carriage wheels. These fear made her stop at the crossing. Lest the carriage wheels or the horse's feet should crowd her down in the slippery street. At last came one of the merry troop. Merry means joyous. Merry means joyous, happy. Merry troop. Correct? Merrily. Merriment, noun. To make merry over is a different word. Means laugh at, means mock at, means ridicule. Don't. Correct? Don't do that one. So here, merry troop. Troop is noun, merry is adjective. Merry troop, joyous, happy troop came at last. In that troop, the gayest lady, gay means happy. Gayest meaning is given there. Happiest boy, lady means boy. Happiest boy, one of the happiest boys. Gayest means cheerful. Gayest means merry. So, at last came one of the merry troop. The gayest lady, happiest lady of all the group. Many groups came and left the place. Nobody noticed, but this group had one boy who is the gayest, who is the happiest. He noticed this old woman. I think he got. Now come to the next. What did you do? The gayest lady. He paused beside her and whispered low, "I will help you across if you wish to go." Her aged hand on his strong young arm, she placed, and so without hurt or harm. See the next. What did he do? He paused. Paused means stopped. Meaning is given there. Waited. Stopped for a while. He paused where? Beside her. Beside means by the side of that lady. And whispered. Whisper means speak in a low voice. Whispered, low. What did he say? "I will help you across." The old woman was standing there. Coming near to the old woman, the boy said, "I will help you across if you wish. If you desire to go to the other side of the road, I will help you," he said. Correct? "So I will help you across if you wish. If you desire to go to the other side of the road, I will help you." So he came to the rescue of the old woman. Did she agree? Yes. Immediately, at once, she said yes. Her aged, what did he do? Her aged hand on his strong arms. So what did she do? Immediately, the old woman placed her hand on his strong young arm. Aged hand, strong arm. He was strong. He was courageous. He was brave. He was kind-hearted. So she kept her hand, she placed her hand on his strong young arm. She placed, and so without hurt or harm. So what did he do? He took the lady to the other side of the road. So what is the figure of speech used there? Her aged hand on his strong young arm means she depended on him. She placed. Placed means keep. Place means keep. She kept her hand on his shoulder and he began to cross the road. So he left the old woman on the other side of the road without any harm, without any hurt. She was safe. He took her safely to the other side of the road. Correct? I think you understood. Then he guided the trembling feet along. Trembling feet. Tremble means, is it given there? No. Tremble means shiver. Tremble. Shake. As if in cold. Or shiver. Shivering. Trembling feet along means she was very weak. She was very old. Legs were trembling. Because of cold, because of age. Correct? So, he guided the trembling feet along. Trembling feet means the old woman. It's also synecdoche. Part of the lady is used to describe the whole woman. Along, proud. So, after living there, proud. Proud means aham Allah. Hemme padudu anta. Proud. That his own were firm and strong. Then back again to his friends he went. His young heart happy and well content. So what did he do? He helped her to cross the road. He felt proud of himself. He felt proud of his firmness, his strength. So what made him feel proud? That is his strength. He is strong. He is firm. So that he could help the old woman. Correct? Then back, so leaving the old woman on the other side of the road, what did he do? Then back again he returned. To his friends he went. He went near, he joined his friends again. His young heart, so how did he feel? After helping that old woman, how did he feel? His young heart happy and well content. Contented means satisfied. Contented means satisfied. He felt satisfied. He felt very happy. He felt pleased. So what made him feel proud of himself? That is, he helped an old woman to cross the road. She was very old, she was very weak, she was unable to cross the road. She needed a helping hand. That's why he felt very happy. Correct? Then, so remember, what made the boy happy? Here is an answer. Next, come to the next stanza. Where is the boy now? He joined his friends. They did not come to his help. Correct? Then he said, she is somebody's mother. Boys, you know. For all she is aged and poor and slow. And I hope some fellow will lend a hand to help my mother. You understand? If ever she is poor and gray, when her own dear boy is far away. Correct? She is somebody's mother. She is weak. She is old. She is poor. So he helped. Correct? He helped her hoping that someone would help his mother. In return for his service. Correct? His mother, when she became old, when his own mother would become old, aged, weak, poor. Correct? When her son was not with her. Correct, Sita. She is somebody. So what did the boy tell his friends after helping the old woman? He said, she is somebody's mother. I don't know who that woman is. I don't know where she is from. Correct? She is a stranger, but somebody's mother. She is somebody's mother. Boys, you know. Avalu, yardo, obra thai. Thai. For all, why did I help her? Why did I help then? For all, she is aged, because she is aged, she is old woman, and she is poor, and she is slow. That is why I came to her rescue. I came there. I went there to help her. Why? Because she is old, she is poor, and she is slow. And I hope some fellow, some person will lend a hand, will give a hand, will help whom? To help my mother. Definitely someone will lend his hand to my mother, to help my mother. Someone may help my mother in future. You understand? That is why I helped her. When? When would some fellow, someone will come? If ever she is poor, if my mother is poor, gray, gray means gray hair, old age. In her old age, if she is poor, if she is in her old age, someone will come to my mother's rescue when her own dear boy is far away. Who is the dear boy? Myself. Who is the dear boy? The somebody's son. Correct? Who helped the old woman? Am I right? Definitely, if I am not with her, with my mother, if she is in need of a helping hand, definitely someone will come and rescue. Someone will come and lend his hand to my mother. This is the expectation he had. Khanditavagi nanna thai ondu divasa idre agathe idre avalige sahayada agathe idre khandita innobbaru bartane. ನಾನು ಅವಳೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಇರದೇ ಇರುವಂಥ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಾನೆ ಅಂತ ಇವನು ಊಹಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾನ್ಸಾ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಮದರ್. ವೆರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಮದರ್? ಶೀ ರೀಚ್ಡ್ ಹರ್ ಹೋಮ್. ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್, ಸೇಫ್ಲಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಮದರ್ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಲೋ ಹರ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಹರ್ ಹೋಮ್ ದಟ್ ನೈಟ್. And the prayer she said was, God, be kind to the noble boy who is somebody's son, and pride and joy. What did she pray? And somebody's mother bowed low her head. Manil hogtale tale bagisi devara munde nintukondu en martane. In her home that night, what did she do that night in her prayer? And the prayer she said, what did she say? What did she pray? What did the lady say in her prayer? She said, in her prayer, she prayed for the boy, she prayed for the noble boy, she prayed for the fortune of the noble boy. What did she say? God, be kind. God, be sympathetic. God, be kind to the noble boy. Who is the noble boy? Somebody's son. She prayed, God, be kind to the noble boy, great boy, good boy, a generous boy, kind-hearted boy. Be kind to the noble boy, opposite ignoble. Who is somebody's son? I don't know who is that person. and pride and joy. He is very proud. He is very joyful. So be kind to that noble boy. Correct? This is the prayer she did in her prayer time. Her heart was overflowing with love and gratitude and pride. She felt proud of that boy. She felt very happy, joy. Looking at the boy's character, she was so thankful. She had gratitude for that noble boy. Correct? She was grateful for the boy. She thanked the boy. That means she was impressed by his noble character. Correct? So here, I think you understood. The good character, that is the helping nature, inspired every reader. Correct? Reader of this text. It gives inspiration for all the students, for all the boys, for all the girls, for all the parents, for all the people to help others. Correct? Yeah. Serving hands are holier than praying lips. Correct? So kindness is a virtue. Here in this poem, the boy exposed the great quality of kindness, which is accepted in the society, and he remained in the hearts of every reader. Correct? I think you understood. Now come to the next question answer part. Now come to the C1. So I gave you the notes of C1 and C2. No need of any extra explanation. Now come to the C3 part. Pick out the rhyming words in the poem and read them aloud. That you can do. Rhyming words. Correct? Grey day, snow slow, long throng, by I, shout let out, sheep deep, grey way, her stir, feet street, troop group, low go, arm harm, along strong, went content, you know slow, hand understand, grey away, head said, boy joy. These are the rhyming words. Sairam.